good morning or evening, friends. Here's your friendly.
Good day, Warren G. Harding students and families. Thank you so much for tuning in today. I'll be taking time today to share some information about our virtual commencement ceremony that will be held to honor and recognize the Warren G. Harding High School class of 2020. Naturally, the first question many folks have is, what is this virtual ceremony? This will be a ceremony made up of recorded segments arranged to reflect a more traditional ceremony. Your participation will be very real. And what makes it virtual is that it will be enjoyed remotely via online and broadcast at the date and time of our originally scheduled commencement on May the 21st. Traditional elements such as student speakers, music, fond reflections, and the most important element, each graduate being featured, taking that symbolic walk from one side of the stage to the next, will be preserved. In addition to those traditional aspects, we will have the flexibility to add a few special touches, allow each of you to add your own personal touch on the ceremony, and incorporate a surprise guest or two to make this event all the more special. The next logical question is, how did we arrive at this? School was initially canceled for 3 weeks on March the 12th. On March 18th, I reached out to Packard Music Hall to reserve the venue for August 9th, anticipating that we would be in this very situation. From that point on, Mr. Shiro and I met regularly to discuss a number of contingency plans for commencement as this pandemic evolved. I found out early on from our senior class officers that the most important thing to them this year and their peers was to have an opportunity to walk that stage. And that's what we planned for. A later date for Packard was reserved. Mr. Shiro directed me to begin to make initial plans to hold a socially distanced ceremony at Mollenkopf Stadium. And as things continued to develop and more information came from the state, we also began to entertain the idea of a virtual or a remote ceremony. The evening of April 23rd, the Ohio Department of Education released guidance and directives regarding graduation ceremonies. Governor DeWine reiterated that guidance Wednesday, April the 29th. That information directed schools in Ohio to not have ceremonies where there would be any gatherings, even with social distancing. So that eliminated the Mollenkopf option. They also advised schools to not reschedule ceremonies to later in the summer with the expectation that we would then be able to gather. So that removed the option of Packard Music Hall in August. They did lay out three options. One, a drive-through diploma distribution. You drive up, I hand you a diploma, and then you drive away. To me, graduation is more significant than that. The second option was to schedule small groups to come in for the stage walk. However, groups of 10 for this eliminated the opportunity to preserve some of the traditional ceremony elements and would also limit our ability to incorporate all this personal and special aspects that will be a part of this virtual ceremony. The virtual ceremony is the third and strongly recommended option for the state. Their recommendation lies in the informed opinion that this option will maximize the safety and health of everyone involved. So how exactly will this virtual ceremony work? Students will pick up their caps and gowns on Friday, May 8th, between 10 and 1 p.m. Detailed times and directions have been communicated in a mailing that should arrive to you May 1st or May 2nd. Cap and gown pickup will happen in a drive-through format with all vehicles entering from Elm Road. Let me remind you that senior dues and any fees must be paid prior to picking up the cap and gown. Take care of that before May 8th to help speed up this pickup process. If you do pay your dues on May 8th, you will have to park at the Panther Drive lot and enter the building to pay the fees, then drive through to pick up the cap and gown. Now at cap and gown pickup, you will receive directions and a scheduled time to report to Harding on either May 13th or 14th to do your personal recording and walk across the stage. In an adjustment to the letter that you'll receive, we are officially inviting you to bring no more than two adults with you on your scheduled day to watch you walk across the stage. Now, this is taking quite a bit of coordination, and families will need to be prepared to be on site for about 2 hours during the time you are scheduled if your family chooses to attend. So, families, call off work, clear your calendar, and be prepared to dedicate the specified time if you want to be a part of that experience with your graduate. Specific report times will be communicated during cap and gown pickup. But for planning purposes, know that students with the last names A through F will be scheduled for May the 13th from 8:30 to noon. Last names beginning with the letters G through O will be on the 13th from 1 to 4 p.m. Students with the last names P through Z will be scheduled for Thursday, May 14th from noon to 3:30. All honors graduates, students graduating with academic excellence, cum laude, magna cum laude, summa cum laude, and our class president will be scheduled from 8:30 to noon on May 14th, with the student speakers being scheduled for first thing in the morning. Adherence to those timelines and dates are crucial, as we want everyone to be a part of this experience and be able to do so safely. You will enter at the designated door, conduct the stage walk, sit for a professional photo in your cap and gown, of which an 8x10 print will be mailed to you. And lastly, you will have the opportunity to record a brief greeting and personal expression that will be part of our virtual ceremony. While I truly believe this will be an awesome event when all is said and done, I know it's not ideal. The presence of all your friends, of your entire family, the crowd, the excitement cannot be replaced. However, during this time, the safety of everyone is simply paramount. The virtual ceremony will be filled with a number of special guests and surprises that would not be possible any other way. Your friends and families from all over the country can tune in and have an excellent view of you and the ceremony. And you will have a visual record of these events that can be shared for a lifetime. And for the families who are viewing, I know you feel the same sense of disappointment at not being able to experience the traditional commencement experience, especially if this was your only shot to do so. In fact, I have someone with me here today who can relate a bit better than I can.
Thanks, Mr. Capers. Hi, Raiders and Raider families. I am Amy Clemente, one of the supervisors here at Harding High School. But today I'm speaking as a mom, Nick's mom, mother of a class of 2020 Warren G. Harding senior. The senior class, their families and friends just recently received the news that graduation would be held virtually. Sadness and disappointment hit us all, even if you may have seen it coming. Before the decision was made, I read many suggestions for alternatives to the traditional graduation ceremony on social media. I loved how the community was creatively looking at resources available to make this event memorable. I too was throwing out ideas. What I've learned in my 25 years in this district is that people of Warren love their kids. Now that we know that the format of graduation, we can start to let it settle in, eventually accept it, start thinking, planning, creating how to make our virtual graduation night for our seniors one that is uniquely them. Please know that as I am speaking to you, I am speaking to myself. From the first day of kindergarten, we envisioned graduation. I can recall seeing the sign in front of my son's school when dropping him off on that first day of kindergarten. Welcome, class of 2020. Without spoiling it for my kid, I'd like to share some ideas I've been thinking of for our family and maybe yours on graduation night. Try setting up a Zoom meet with family and friends to experience the event together. We will have a grandma join in from a nursing home, sisters living in another state and city. A brother-in-law can join us from his deployment on the other side of the globe. These loved ones would not be able to attend otherwise. You can put a sign out in the front of your house, honk for the grad. Bake a cake or cupcakes. Deliver them to family and friends to celebrate together. Celebrate using FaceTime. Decorate your car, your front door. Take a walk in your cap and gown through your neighborhood. I'm sure your neighbors would love to give shout outs. Make a special meal or order out your favorite food. Be creative. Be safe. but above all, make it memorable and joyous. You are making history. Please document and share. Take pictures, make TikToks, Snapchats, post Instagram, and Facebook. Show us your graduation night. You earned that diploma. We can't wait to see what's next. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Thank you, Ms. Clemente. Thanks for your time, and as always, don't hesitate to reach out. Remember to pay those dues and fees prior to cap and gown pickup and get those specific instructions for the stage walk when you secure that cap and gown. Now, students, they shut down our Office 365 chat, so you can't reach me there, but find me on Twitter, send me an email, or call. I'd love to hear any feedback and contributions you have. Take care, Raiders. Congratulations, graduates, and see everyone soon.